Welcome to this practice on CSS properties or tutorial introducing the box model. One question. In a CSS box model, all HTML elements can be considered as boxes. The CSS box models represents the design and layout of the site. It consists of margins, borders, paddings, and the actual content. The properties work in the same order, top, right, bottom, or left. The image below illustrates the box model. Content. What order do the properties work in the box? Bottom left. Understanding the box model. More on box models. Every element on the web page is a box. CSS uses the box model to determine how big the boxes are and how to place them. The box is also used to calculate the actual width and height of the HTML element. The box model is also used to calculate the actual width and height. This is the box model. Every element on the web page is a box. Total width of an element. When working with boxes, it is important to understand how the total width of an element is calculated. For example, the total width of the box with padding will be the sum of widths plus padding left and padding right. Padding left, padding right. Total width. Okay. Here's another box with margins, borders, and padding. The total width is the sum of the left and right margins, left and right borders, left and right padding, and the actual width of the content. Margin left, border left, padding left, margin, padding right, border right, margin right, total width. When you set the width and height properties of an element with CSS, you set the width and height of the content area. When setting a background color to a box, it covers the content area as well as the padding. The background column of the content also covers padding and margin. Padding. Padding, I guess. Total height of an element. The total height of an element is calculated the same way as the width. The example below is the same box from the previous lesson with padding, borders, and margins. Margin. To summarize, total element's height equals height plus top padding plus bottom padding plus top border plus bottom border plus margin plus bottom margin. In the total width of an element in pixels, if its width is left and right padding. Each border width and margin. Okay, that's 55, 16, and 164. I mean, right padding, left padding, border. Okay, 174 borders. The border property. The CSS border property. The CSS border property allows you to customize the border of HTML elements. In order to add borders to the element, you need to specify the size, style, and color of the border. The example below shows how to add a solid green border to the paragraph. The HTML. P. This is an example of a solid border. P. Padding. Border. Solid green. Okay. Size, style, color. There are three properties describing the border are size, style, color, border width. Properties for the border can be set separately. The border width property specifies the width of the border. First, padding, border style, solid, border width. Border color. The border color of the element can be defined using a color name, RGB or hex value. P class. Hex value. None of the borders property will have any effect unless the border style property is set. Border style property. Fill in the blank to set the border style. The border style property. The default value of the border style is none, which defines no border. There are various styles supported for the border style properties. Dotted, dash, double, etc. The example below illustrates the difference between them. Motors down on dotted dash double groove rigid inset outset hidden. Border. Cool. In CSS, it is possible to specify different borders for different size using the following properties: border top style, border right style, border bottom style, and border left style for the corresponding side. And drop from the options below to set the border style for the element of the element to solid and make it 5. Border style, border size, border, border width, border style, border width, border size, border color, damn it, border style, border width, border color, width and height. CSS width and height. To style a div element to have a total width and height of 100 pixels. The HTML. The total width and height of this element is 100 pixels. Div border. With a piece of solid green. Width 90. Height 90 pixels. Okay, well, because 50 and 50, right? Total width and height of the box will be the 90 pixels plus 5 borders plus 5 borders equals 100 pixels. Fill in the blanks to set the height of a div to 50 pixels width to 100 pixels. Div to 50 pixels. Width and height measurements. The width and height of an element can also be assigned using percents. In the example below, the width of an element is assigned in percentage. The height is in pixels. Total width of this element is 100%. And the total height is 100 pixels. Div. Solid green. Result. With the height usually expressed in pixels and percentage. Minimum and maximum size. To set the minimum and maximum height and width of an element, you can use the following properties: min width, min height, maximum width of an element, minimum height of an element, the maximum width of an element, max width, max height, the maximum height of an element. In the example below, we set the minimum height and maximum width of different paragraphs to 100 pixels.
first, second. Okay, set the minimum allowable width of the dip to 200 pixels. Background color. Background color property. The background color property is used to specify the background color of an element, the HTML. The background color of this page is set to light sky blue, CSS. Body. Background color. What property is used to describe the background color? 36. The background color values. Dime, amor. Okay, congratulations. The color, background color values. The color of the background can be defined using three different formats. A color name, hexadecimal values on RGB. You want a bailecito? You gotta speak in English because I'm making a video. Bailecito, go ahead. No, I don't like the season too. You finish. Go ahead. Go ahead, go ahead. Okay. In the example below, the body, H1 and P elements are assigned different backgrounds, colors. H1, this is the heading. This is the paragraph. Body. Background color. Background color. Background color. Fill in the blanks to make the background color of the elements with the ID match style black using HTML colors definition. Background image. The background image property. The background image property says one or several background images in an element. Let's set a background image for the body element. Background. Background image URL. Background color. The URL specifies the path of the image. File, both relative and absolute path are supported. By default, the background image is placed on the top left corner of an element, as is repeated both vertically and horizontal to cover the entire element. What is the correct format for the image path? of the background image property. What was this one? The background image property. Background image can be set not only for the whole page, but for individual elements as well. Below we set a background image for the P element. Background image URL. Color white. To specify more than one image, just separate the URL with commas. Body. Fill in the blanks. Background repeat. The background repeat property. The background repeat property specifies how the background image shall be repeated. The background image can be repeated along the horizontal axis, the vertical axis, both axes, or not repeated at all. The repeat dash x will repeat the background images only horizontal. The CSS body. Background image URL. Background repeat. Repeat. X feet dash X. Okay. The repeat Y will repeat the background images only vertically. If you want the image to be shown only once, use the non repeat value. Makes sense. Fill in the blank to make the background image repeat along the vertical axis. URL. Background. God damn it, I'm an idiot. Background. Okay. Setting the value to inherit. When you set a background repeat property to inherit, it will take the same specified value as a property for the element parent. For example, we set the body background repeat only horizontally. If we set some paragraph background repeat value to be inherit, they will take the same property value as the body element. Yep. Result. This is some paragraph. Values of the background repeat property as if I repeat, non repeat, repeat X, repeat Y, and inherit. God damn it. How you write that? How do you write inherit? Inherit with H. background attachment. Background attachment property. The background attachment property says whether a background image is fixed or scrolls with the rest of the page. Even if a background has a scrolling mechanism, a fixed background doesn't move with the element. When setting a background image with properties, obviously. When setting a background image, which property is obviously background repeat. Obligatory. Image. Background attach values. You can also set a background attachment to inherit or scroll. When you set a background attachment to inherit, it will inherit the value from its parent element. When you set a background attachment to scroll, the background image will scroll with the rest of the content. Inherit property assess the following values: inherit, fix, and styling the list. 3 questions. The list style type property. The CSS list property allows us to set different list items markers. In HTML, there are 2 types of lists: an order list (UL). The list items are marked with bullets. Order list, the list items are marked with numbers or letters. With CSS, list can be style further, and images can be used as the list item mark, the list item markers. One of the ways you use the list style type property, which can be set, one of the ways is to use the list style type property, which can be set to circle, square, decimal, this, lower, alpha, etc. HTML. Lower, alpha. Circle, square, lower, alpha. Lower, alpha. Lower alphabet, circle, square. That's pretty cool. Some of the values are for an order list, and some are order list, and some for order list. List style types apply to the background color of the list, the bullet numbers, number of the list. I meant to hit this bullet number. The bullets are numbering of a list. The list image and position. There are also other list properties such as list style images. It specifies a image to be used as the list item marker. List style position specifies the position of the marker box inside, outside. The example below, we use an image as a list item marker and specify the position of the inside of the content flow.
inside of the content flow. Okay. Unless red, green, following list has list oppositions. Okay. Image URL logo position inside. Okay. Outside is the default value. Which keyword is used to specify the image location address for the URL? The list style property. The list style property is a shorthand property for setting list style types, list style image, and list style proper position. Is used to set all the list properties in one declaration. URL list style square outside none. This will be the same as the longhand version. List style type square position image none. If one of the property values are missing, the default value of the value for the missing property will be inserted, if any. Fill in the blanks. Square. Just the type. Size. Position. Installing the table. The table properties. The look of an HTML table can be greatly improved with CSS. The border collapse property specifies whether the table borders are collapsed into a single border or separated as default. If the borders are separated, the borders spacing property can be used to change the spacing. Border one table border collapse separate border spacing. Okay. The properties regarding table borders are table spacing, table collapse. The caption size property. The caption size property specifies the position of a table caption. The values can be set as top or bottom. In the example below, we specify the placement of a table caption to top. HTML caption. Some of our courses. Course name. Lesson quizzes. See, it's over JavaScript. Caption side top. Caption. Fill in the blanks. To position the caption of the table at the bottom.
What did it say, bro? Caution side. The anti cell property. The anti cell property specifies whether or not the display borders and backgrounds on empty cell in a table on empty cells in a table. Possible values are: show the border of an empty cell are readable. Show border of empty cells are readable. Hidden: the borders of an empty cell are not drawn. Here is the empty cell property that is used to hide borders of empty cells in the table element. Table border collapse, separate empty cell, hide. Fill in the blanks to hide the empty cell of a table. The table layout property. The table layout specifies how the width of a table column is calculated. The possible values are: auto, when a column or cell width are not explicitly set, the column width will be in position to the amount of content in the cell, in the cells that make up the column. Fix, when a column or cell width are not explicitly set, the column width will not be affected by the amount of content in the cell that makes up the column. The table layout is set to auto by default. The example below shows the difference between auto and fix. What is the default value of the table layout property? Styling the links. Setting styles to links. Links can be styled with any CSS properties. Examples: colors, font family, background, etc. In addition, lists can be styled differently depending on what state they are. Whatever is that? Let me see though.
pseudo selectors are available. 8. Link defines the style for the normal unvisited links. 8. Visited defines the style for visited links. 8. Active links become active once you click on it. Hover. A link is hover when the mouse is over it. The example below is created a link that will change the style when the mouse is moved over it. Hover. Target blank. This link is hover when the mouse over it. The link from the above example will look like this. When the mouse over it, it becomes red as we define in the style sheet. When styling, the style for several links stays are some other rules. A hover must come after a link. And a visited. Some other rules. A hover must come after a link. And a visitor visited. A active must come after a hover. Well, let's look at that. Of what type are the link visited, active, and hover selectors? Whatever that was. Links. Text decoration. By default, text links are underlined by the browser. One of the most common uses of CSS with links is to remove the underline. In this example below, the text decoration property is used to remove the underline. Text decoration and a link. The following properties are used to control the look and feel of the link of a links of links. Borders. None. Remove borders from images with links. Also outline. None. Remove the dotted borders on click links in E. What value is used to remove borders of images with links? Customize the mouse cursor. Setting the mouse cursor style. CSS allows you to set your desired cursor style when you mouse over an element. For example, you can change your cursor into a hand icon, help icon, and much more, rather than using the default pointer. In the example below, the mouse pointer is set to a help icon when we mouse over this spam element. Spam style curse. Sir, help. Do you need help? Which property allows to change the style of the mouse cursor? Which property allows to change the style of a mark cursor? Cursor. Idiot. Cursor. The cursor property values. There are numerous other possibilities, possible values for the cursor property, such as default cursor, crosshair, cursor displays as cursor, pointer, cursor displays, hand icon. The list of possible values is quite long. The image below demonstrates the various available styles. Cool. What values of the cursor property displays a plus icon? Crosshair. Is it like that? Higher. The default value. Usually, the appearance of the mouse cursor is altered to provide a more interesting experience for web visitors. However, choosing the wrong cursor style can be misleading as well. For example, if the cursor value is set to default, users might not see the link. Choose your mouse cursor style carefully. Drag and drop from the options below to make the cursor appear as a pointer on paragraphs. Cursor pointer. Quiz 3, model 3 quiz, 4 questions. Add the padding values so that it has 10 pixels to the top, 15 pixels to the bottom, 5 pixels to the right, 10 pixels to the left. 10 pixels to the top, 15 pixels to the bottom, 5 pixels to the right, 10 pixels to the left. Padding. All right. Top. Bottom. Yep. How do you make a list not display bullet points? List has none. Fill in the blanks. Underline text. Cursor. Cursor. closer. Text. Decoration. Border. Cursor. And how do you write cursor? Cursor. Okay.
Make the cursor appear as a crosshair on all links of the web page.
Good then, cursor.